Hey guys, it's your boy Kervis, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 at Fine Art Current Mode, where last time I lost off. Picked up two more wins in the league. I have another two wins in the league, but so, who do you guys who may be sick of? For those of you who are sick of league football, in the next episode, will reward you for all your patience with a league match in the Dutch Cup. But first, I have to take on Roda and Ajax in the league. Now, of course, Ajax is going to be a more interesting match. I'm not going to fill out these guys. I don't know.
Three in midfield, which managers like to have that extra solidity.
Yeah, that's right.
So I'm not gonna rule them out from being. You know, they might surprise me if I do rule them out. So yeah, I'm not gonna do that.
It's going to be very tough for the opposition today to break down the home team's defense.
Average. Boost the ball. And he wins it back.
It's not happened forgotten, that's for sure.
All the fun of this wintry game.
And his tackle.
Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing.
Kramer was in alert. He was alert. That could have been a big moment.
They've lost the ball.
Wait. Ohana. One player runs away from it, and the other guy is standing there, not trying to get in front of the defender to get at the pass.
Play here, but it's out for a throw-in. Elia,
the opposite. Elia,
they could be in trouble. And the ball gets
whip it in.
The goalkeeper has done well to stop that one.
Freaking hell, that was almost an own goal, which would have been very. Yeah.
Goalkeeper.
Much like the last episode, because it was a very unusual ongoing episode as well.
Very good control, they've lost the ball. Kramer.
You'll have to go and watch the episode if you want to find out what happened. Count!
So the corner to come.
Count hits the crossbar. How unlucky can the guy get? Watch this. This is a fantastic shot. Bang the crossbar. It almost looks like it hits the post as well, but I don't think it did. Maybe it did? It didn't look like it did. It would have bounced out if it did. Just hold over the line. Berg will handle that. And I accidentally put out for a throw for Roda. That's easily dealt with. Allow me. Go stand it up. Yes! Oh, great save from the Hiroda keeper.
Tries to punch it away.
Cross in. Stender will get that. That's it. Ah, covered offside.
Well,
It's mine. Sherwin, close to the box. Valhanna.
Of all the decisions that are difficult to get right on a regular basis, offside.
Oh, thank God he was offside. I was gonna say, what was that?
Good one in this case.
Well, it wasn't a chance to really get in at goal.
Say again, that's three in a row.
About the decisions that footballers make, I think his manager's feeling like that anyway.
It's good to know how much longer there is. This
Kramer.
Commentating. We've got 2 added minutes.
Loses the ball. Oh, they gave it back to me. Elia! Oh! Yes! 1-0 just before halftime. And it's the man himself, Mark Stendera.
That is a wonderful goal, Alan.
Well, the keeper quite rightly asking one or two questions of his defenders who didn't react as quickly as the goal scorer.
Let's see the replay now.
Even with the defenders around him, he could really miss. And it is 1-0.
That has opened the scoring.
Just before halftime, that is brilliant.
Everyone settling back in their seats. Second half is underway. El Hero Elliot.
There. Valhanna. Valhanna. What's the challenges? Stenda! He scored again! 2 goals for him, 2 goals for Feyenoord, 2-0.
You can see a slightly different viewpoint.
The defender is probably kicking himself that he didn't connect with the challenge. He probably would have gotten a booking for it, but it would have prevented the goal. Ifs and buts do not win matches. Goals win matches.
Trying to stretch the position using the wider areas here. Juric.
And this team and that defender, they can't dwell on what could have happened. And Kramer loses the ball. Oh, Kramer, that's a few times that's happened. You're not having any luck today. You know what? I think I'm gonna make a sub. And bring on Ruben. Or Robin. However you pronounce it. Hang on. I noticed the own time of these. He's wrecked. Freaking hell. How is he so tired after 2016 minutes?
On the bench, a substitute is clearly getting ready to come on.
Well, if that was substitution, then you can have a bit of rest. Here come Ruben. And for the first time this season, I'm pretty sure. Here comes the Vajinovic. I can't pronounce this guy's name. Vajinovic. That's gonna be my last and probably best.
Good stop by the goalkeeper.
bit. He loses the ball. Well, maybe it's not just Kramer. Ah, man, if I had handballs on, that would have been a free kick. He clearly struck the, I want to say midfielder, but I assume midfielder. Maybe he's a striker.
Maybe work something more significant in front of goal from the throw.
I'm not sure what kind of formation this team is running. I kind of skip past that. Great tackle by Hinoya. Here we go.
And he could get away.
Make it. Enjoy the run. Stender doesn't need him. He finishes his hat trick. I think that might put him above Kramer. Into the top goal scorer for Mark. I think that's 14 goals for Stender.
Was perhaps the place where it was impossible to save it. No goalkeeper could
have
reached that. It clips the post on the way in.
Goals.
Yeah, really good strike. He took it early as well, and I think that's what...
I'm pretty sure Kramer has 13.
One team really on their game today. The other very off colour. Substitute coming up for the away team. Just working away to try and find an opening. And here's the shot.
Come on, Van Berg.
See the deflection there.
I have a corner, but it was willed. I defended the attack well enough anyway. And it's an easy take for the keeper.
Going to be a substitution. It's
one. Rubens hunting for the ball. Can't get it. Congolo. Elia. Go. Go, 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 go. And,
excellent block there.
I'll play, and that's probably going to mean the end of the match. Kelly's going to chase us, and I don't think he's going to get it. And there's the full-time whistle, so it didn't matter anyway. 3-0 is the final score, then they're getting all three goals.
Quite often, last 10 or 15.
Not a clean sheet for Murray and my goal. So, yeah.
Brilliant performance from this fella.
And another great performance from one of my best signings ever. And I truly mean that. He is really that good. Now he has 75 finishing. Way! The big question is, did that put him atop the top goalscorer ranking? It did. Kramer does have 13, Stenda has gone above him. What are the freaking chances? All of a sudden, it's a very close again. Sorry, drinking all my Diet Coke. Okay, so most normally it'd be water, but there's no water in the house. Except tap. You have a fizzy beverage in the house, you drank it. That is neither here nor there. Let's get into this game against Ajax. The last league game before I finally play a cup game, which will be the first game of the next season.
We're in Amsterdam today, the Amsterdam Arena.
The Amsterdam Arena is our stadium. I was looking forward to playing. Yeah. This is my... I think I mentioned this. Maybe I didn't. This is my first career mode that I've done with any Dutch team in like 5 or 6 years.
The three-pronged attack, it can be really potent, but it can be awkward as well.
Bringing up and giving the Eredivisie its props.
These days, isn't it? The 4-3-3 gives you the...
What used to turn me off is that even after you win, you still have to win a playoff. Like how you do in MLS. But thankfully they've changed that. Whoever finishes top actually wins the league. Because, you know, that makes perfect sense. Unlike the person who doesn't finish top. Like, instead of having got in playoffs, that's the way you're gonna have it, you know, instead of having a league, just have a goddamn tournament for the trophy. Imagine the Premier League was decided like that. The 20 teams were drawn into a competition. 4 teams get a bye. So, like, say if they did that next season, and the 4 teams who get the bye are the teams who finish the top 4, so City, Arsenal, Spurs, and Leicester. And the other 16 teams have to go through who will figure this tournament. Until some description. It would be the freaking chaos! Yes. Everyone would be massively confused. They'd be like, wait, what's going on?
Well, he's hit it. Hard and true. The goalkeeper doesn't have to move. David Klaassen. And it's with Ajax now. The referee's pointed.
That could easily set up for a scenario where you see a lot of more underdogs winning in the Premier League if it was decided in a tournament fashion instead of a league. I don't know how many people would be too happy with that. So luckily, it's not how it's decided.
On his left side, he's so dangerous. Well, it was a striker's instinct there because there wasn't a lot of room in that box.
And that is a fantastic goal. 4 goals in 2 games this episode from Mark Stendera. The Ajax number 10
has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Is that Dion? Matt Dion? I don't know Ajax's. I can't recite the Ajax players off by heart with their numbers because I don't know them. Like I said, I haven't really paid attention to the Eredivisie in about 5 or 6 years.
Cut out the pass.
If I don't plan to do it,
go on the attack maybe.
Normally, if I plan to do it, we'll play through a league. I normally keep him there. I'm up for how the team might plan to do the career mode or doing in real life. the league is going on at the same time, which normally it is, because that's when the FIFA comes out at the same time.
We're rushing to take the corner, then a goal to the good, of course.
And of course, we're at the start. I normally compare to how they did last season. I'm like, okay, the first time, you know, would ideal would be to do better than they did last. But in real life, finished third, you know. So that's the league. That the ideal league goal is to finish at least second. But I always aim for first. You'll never hear me saying, I don't mind if I finish second. I want to win! Very competitive person. When it comes to career mode, you know, if you're not winning, you're not... You may as well not even bother playing a career mode. Because if you're not winning anything, I mean, even with lower, like if you're in England and you're doing a Road to Glory, even if you're winning the league, that's still you winning something. And the lower league teams also have the, that paint trophy thing.
Change of end.
That they partake in.
Second half is
for League 1 and League 2 teams. That's interesting.
The shot's up!
Lemony! Ooh! Shot was looking for the top corner. Just missed it.
Maybe Klaassen.
No. Kramer. Helps. Barrett! Oh! Dirk. That was the moment.
A decent fist away by the keeper. From this position, they can...
Play out for a throw as the keeper. Alamedi. Count. Put in. Oh, come on, Kramer. You're a big, lanky striker. That's what big, lanky strikers are best at. Entering the goddamn ball. Oh. Freaking asshole. And doing what he's supposed to be doing.
Alamedi.
Lemony.
David Klaassen.
Kramer is losing out on the ball again. The Klaassen is there on the 10th. Okay. I'm going up the young. I can't imagine. Going to assume someone was telling me off in the comments about where Luke De Jong is. But before I could, zero foot, which was well known to us FIFA players as one of those guys you can sign who has a really high potential, equalized. Right, have to take this seriously now. Don't really have a... Gonna have to play Tornstara in,
That's gone really...
CM.
Far too hard the corner, and it's out for a throw. Oh, we're going to see a triple substitution now. David Klaassen.
How did you not win that? Okay, Mr. Bujanovic did.
Quite good there, the Martin. Produced some majestic stuff.
Count. Crosses blocked.
Pretty easy to cope with by the defending team.
Come on, Stojanovic. Come on, Ruben.
Back to him again. David Klaassen. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
In there. Count. Go. Go. Count doesn't have the pace. Ruben.
Put it in well. Tries to punch it away. Shots on him. Both managers, I think, are trying to win it here. That's why it's such a captivating contest.
To go all attack. I'm not dropping points. Cows. Move it in. Why? He's whipping it in too close to the keeper. I may as well bring it into the box myself. Ooh. Oh, hell yeah. Ruben. Go back. Torrance! Come on, put the ball down. Come on! Somebody hit the ball in the back of the net, please! None of you are listening, mate!
Well, only 2 more minutes to be added on.
Benedic. Gonna have one more chance. Kongolo. Oh. Kongolo! Oh, no! 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 No!
A draw, Alan Lock.
Damn it!
A lack of chances created, Martin, was there? But on the day.
And December again! What is it with December and me dropping points in career modes? Modes. God damn it! And again against one of the teams you'd consider my rival, those for the league title. Son of Chelsea, AC Milan, Bayern Munich. Ajax, it always seems to happen. Why? Seriously, if I ever become a real life football manager, and if that ever first started happening to me in real life, I'd say to him, hey players, you don't get a Christmas break until this shit stops happening. Unfortunately, I can't take away their Christmas break. Picking in because that's not a feature. I don't know. What do I need to do to stop this from happening? Because it always seems to. I don't know. Maybe I'm gonna have to. Maybe I'm gonna have to bring in some players into the free transfer window. I don't have that much money. Yeah, I'll have to go for loans. This team, I can't see what's the problem. I can't see what the problem is. It's not specifically this team. It's something about the month of December and me playing one of my big rivals. I do not know. What the hell is going on? Can somebody please explain to me why I dominate all season, but every season in my each of my secondary career modes, and in the very first season of my Liverpool career mode, in December, when I played one of my big title rivals, I dropped points for no apparent reason. It boggles the mind. Normally it's a 0-0 draw. This time it was 1-1. I don't know. Do I have to spend? And if so, what do I have to buy? Do I have to buy a striker? Is Kramer not good enough? Is his 13, where his 13 goals not good enough? I mean, he didn't score in this episode. He didn't do shit in this episode. He was terrible. Or is it my defense? Is my defense not good enough? What is happening? Why does this keep happening? Please, someone, tell me. Please. Let me know in the comment section below, and until next time. Make sure you like if you enjoyed this episode, subscribe if you're new to the channel. You can watch me be tormented again next career mode in December. Yay!